Google unveiled so many amazing updates during their Google I.O. 2021 keynote. So I'm going to break down what the top 10 announcements were and what they mean for you. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custody, and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and a ton of Google content. So today I'm gonna break down the top 10 announcements from Google I/O 2021, because it's great when these companies make big, flashy announcements, but what do they actually mean for you, the consumer? Well, let's find out. And by the way, you're gonna wanna stick around to the end because we're gonna be running through major Google Workspace updates. And when I say major, I mean major. But first, let's talk about Android 12. Announcement number one, Google has given users a sneak peek of Android 12 in what appears to be the biggest design update in years. Android 12 features a design they call Material U. There are smoother animations, bigger buttons, the ability to change some system colors, and a few other features. It's what I would call a rather playful design. Android 12 showcases some lock screen changes as well as changes to the overall widget system. There's even some new privacy features, including an all-new privacy dashboard that'll tell you camera, microphone, and location access, among other permissions. The biggest thing to take away from this Android 12 update is Google says this Material U system will be applied cross-platform. So think web, apps, hardware, and Android. Google I/O 2021 announcement number two. Select Pixel and Samsung Galaxy phones will work as digital car keys with Android 12. Right now, this ability uses NFC and UWB technology. However, as of right now, BMW is the only automaker that has actually confirmed support of this digital car key. But don't fret, in the near future, other automakers will follow suit. Announcement number three, Google and Samsung are merging Google's Wear OS with Samsung's Tizen-based system. This is going to be a massive upgrade for Google's smartwatch system. These two platforms merge together just to be known as Wear moving forward, although that name can change. Google's pushing that this merge will result in better battery life, 30% faster app load time, and some smoother animations. So what does this mean for you, the user? Well, it allows Google to offer you a better selection of devices and apps, as well as custom watch faces. Google I/O announcement number four. Let's talk Google AI, shall we? Essentially, Google is showcasing its Lambda AI that understands language better than ever before. They did this via a demo here that you're watching, where they showed what it would be like to have a chat with everyone's favorite planet, Pluto. And for the record, they also demoed what it would look like to talk to a paper airplane, but that's neither here nor there. So in effect, what's happening here is Lambda was able to answer questions as Pluto and also able to answer questions as a paper airplane, referencing facts about each throughout the conversations. The real implications here for us mere mortals is that Google is flexing their AI language learning abilities. Huh? A lot of Google's AI work focuses on the retrieving of information. So think like translating a language or providing users with correct answers when they search the web. So ergo, if Google can get AI to understand language better, it can offer improvements to users across their suite of platforms. Number five on the list, Project Starline. Are you ready for your mind to be blown? This is probably one of the coolest things I have ever seen. You might want to sit down for this because the future, it's here. Project Starline is a 3D video chat booth that's designed to make you feel like you're sitting right here with someone in person. That's right, the person you're chatting with will appear in front of you in 3D. You'll be able to see them from different angles and even make eye contact. Project Starline's using multiple cameras and sensors in order to create a 3D model. So right now, this means both parties in the video chat would need to have this technology, which is literally like a big booth right now, consisting of all of this fancy gear. But how cool is this glimpse into the future? And you have to keep in mind that when any new technology comes out, it's big and cumbersome at first, so this can only improve with time. Think about it. It's like you and I could be having this conversation right now from wherever we are in the world, but in person. By the way, if you're finding this video helpful so far, be sure to give it a like and remember to subscribe to my channel for more content like this. Okay, moving on to announcement number 6. Ooh, this one includes some much needed camera inclusivity updates. With this camera update, Google's looking to ensure the processor does a better job of rendering darker skin tones and natural hairstyles. So for this, Google's using auto white balance and exposure algorithms to improve the accuracy for dark skin tones. It's easy for me to sit here as the palest white girl ever and take these auto processing functionalities for granted. Historically, these processors are built and designed to auto balance on a skin tone like mine or similar to mine. So with these upgrades, Google is hoping to avoid common over brightening and desaturating people of color. Google I/O announcement number 7, Google's new health tool. And listen, I'm just gonna tell you right now, if you're a hypochondriac, ooh, look away, look away. Google's hoping to launch this new health tool later this year with a focus on skin conditions. Why skin conditions? Well, believe it or not, Google gets about 10 billion skin condition questions every year. So with their new health tool, you can take a picture of your skin condition, and then you'll answer a series of questions, and Google will provide you with a list of possible conditions that it's programmed to recognize. The more the tool is used, the more the AI learns. Insert obvious warning here. This is not a replacement for a board-certified dermatologist. And if you have anxious tendencies, you might want to stay away from this one altogether. Announcement number 8. There are important Google Photos updates. There's actually a couple of good ones here. So first, users will be able to store photos in a locked folder, meaning you can create password-protected space on your phone. So the photos won't actually appear when you're scrolling through them in the Photos app. They'll only be available in that password-protected spot. This is going to come to Pixel first, but it will be available on other Android devices somewhere later in the year. But that's not the only Google Photos update. This next one is a real trip. You'll now be able to make animated photos from stills. So Google is calling this feature Cinematic Moments, and it uses 2 still photos to create a moving image. How neat is that? And number 9 on the list, Google Maps updates. I know, when is Google Maps not being updated? But there's some really good additions here. So first, they're adding more route updates to reduce hard braking when you're driving. So Google's going to use some machine learning and navigation information to give you a heads up on whether or not traffic is suddenly slowing. Their hope is to reduce a lot of accidents that happen due to hard braking. Second, Live View is getting an update, and it's going to include things like details about shops and restaurants around you, helpful new street signs at busy or important or major intersections, and if you're traveling, Live View will tell you where you are in relation to your hotel, which is super helpful. If you're wondering what the heck Live View even is, you can click on this video up here in the cards for a detailed view of Live View. Third, you'll be able to spot busy areas at a glance just upon opening up the Google Maps app, which can help you avoid crowded areas. And lastly, Google Maps will tailor your map to highlight the best places based on the time of day and whether or not you're traveling. So this is going to be personalized to each individual user. And my wonderful little custodians, you have made it to Google I/O announcement number 10. And you might have guessed it, Google Workspace integrations. Oh, my Google Workspace lovers, welcome to your all new smart canvas. Google wants to make your Google Workspace even more collaborative. So you might be familiar with at mentioning people in Google Docs, but soon you're going to be able to at mention not only people, but files and meetings too. And this will also be available in Sheets in the coming months as well. So this is an easy way to be able to hyperlink to other docs and sheets and meetings right from the file you're working in. Now, Google is also introducing pageless docs, so it'll be easier for you to work with wider tables or larger images. And of course, you'll be able to add emoji reactions to docs. But that's not all. There will be a new assistive writing feature that will offer more inclusive language recommendations, like say mail carrier instead of mailman, as an example. There's also going to be new docs template that's going to automatically import any relevant info from your calendar invites or other attached files. That's huge. There's going to be connected checklists, table templates in docs, plus the ability to work in Google Meet directly from your doc, sheet, or slide. Wowza. That's right. You're going to be able to see and hear each other right from the collaborative file you're working on together. There's even going to be live captions and translations in Google Meet, plus a really handy timeline view in Sheets. And speaking of Sheets, there will be better assisted analysis functionality to help you build cell formulas. And finally, you'll be able to create and edit sheets, docs, and slides from Google Chat Rooms. Google really wants you to look at your Google Workspace as a smart canvas. And if you're feeling a little overwhelmed about all of these updates that Google has made to Workspace, just leave a comment below and let me know if you want a full, detailed, dedicated video on all the Google Workspace updates. Plus, I have a ton of other Google videos linked below if your heart so desires. So what do you think of the top 10 announcements from Google I/O 2021? Let everyone know your favorites in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more Google content. Thanks for watching and see you next time.